RGP arrived on the Sunday, and he asked us, did we know that Aaron had Wolf Parkinson-White syndrome? And we said, no, we never even ever heard of Wolf Parkinson-White syndrome. He went on to tell us that Aaron was diagnosed with Wolf Parkinson-White syndrome when he was 16 in his surgery. But at that particular time, when the GP was telling us this, everything was very vague because we were in a state of shock. The whole time was just a blur. After a couple of weeks and we sort of got ourselves settled down, we wanted to know, we started to ask questions. I made an appointment to see the consultant. The consultant told me that Aaron had came and seen him. And I asked the consultant what information he'd given. I asked him, did he tell him to go and tell his parents? He said, no, he didn't tell him to tell his parents. The only information Aaron was given was that if he took an attack, he was to put his head between his legs, and that in possibly 3 years he'd been needing an ablation, but he had nothing to worry about. And that's the quote I had from the consultant, and that's exactly what Aaron done. We could ask the question as a family, why did Aaron not tell us? But we can answer that. I feel myself personally that Aaron was told he had nothing to worry about, and that was the words that Aaron probably wanted to hear. And Aaron went out there and lived his life. None of us were ever angry. We were just in a state of shock and sadness, and the sadness of not having Aaron about us, not having Aaron there in the morning, not having Aaron there in the evening. I don't think blaming is the right thing, but Aaron put his life in their hands when he was 16. He went as a young boy at 16 to the medical people. And then Aaron was diagnosed with Wolf Parkinson-White syndrome, and Wolf Parkinson-White syndrome is a heart condition that can kill you. And he put his faith in them.
We had a football match on the Friday night, and then it was just normal weekend, like, and then on the Monday morning, that's when the pain started. The first one wasn't the hand really tell it, and then it got worse and worse. Then about 12, I had to phone the ambulance because I just couldn't bear the pain anymore. I didn't find out I had the problem until it was the next day. That's when the doctor came. He told me I had Wolf Parkinson-White. It was just weird finding out I'd sat there, and all the people in the hospital, they were like 80 or 90, and I was 21 sitting there, and it just was unbelievable to find out that someone like that there. Like, I got the warning signs first, and you know, could go in and get the operation. It doesn't happen that you usually be that lucky, like, so I was just so glad I was that lucky. Like, I'm back now to try and play football, and I can go out now with my friends and just enjoy myself, like, so you know, I've nothing to worry about, and it's all behind me, so it's great. Like,
after Aaron died, I struggled with my life for a long time. Struggled to come to terms with it. I sort of became nearly semi-recluse. I wasn't interested in life. I wasn't really interested in anything. I was doing things, but I wasn't really doing them. But when I realised this is not what Aaron would want me to do, that was when I changed. I would imagine most people in the same situation as me may feel like that. You go out there and all of a sudden life is going, everybody is going about their business. And that's reality. And your son's not there, your daughter's not there, but the world, life is going on. And that is reality. I find that difficult. I find that very difficult. But that's part of grieving, and that's, I had to go that journey and do that there to get where I am today. If I could start again, a million miles away, I would keep myself, I would find a way. Thank you.
We first met with John Lundy early in the year 2006, and we decided to run with Cardiac Risk in the Young to promote screening in Northern Ireland. That screening clinic opened in November 2006, and since then we've been promoting it. General response to the clinics is good, and working with CRI, we're trying to arrange more clinics. We want to have a monthly clinic on a continuous basis. The numbers have been increasing, and there's more demand from clubs and individuals.
What CRI is doing in Northern Ireland, I feel, is very positive. It's for the well-being of young people. It's not to scare anyone. And I would appeal to all parents for the well-being of the kids to have them screened. It costs £35, and I still believe it's the best £35 they'll ever spend.